Have you heard that ginger can help with gut health, but you're not exactly sure how or why? If so, then stick around because that is what we are going to talk about today. By the end of this video, you will know whether ginger can help with pain, inflammation, digestion in general, and nausea. But before we go on, please hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, hit the bell next to the subscribe button. All that helps my video go up in organic search so that I can keep making these videos for you. Let's start by talking about what ginger is. Ginger is a flowering plant, and the ginger root is the root of that plant. That is what's used in the products that you're used to having ginger in. So this is what the root looks like. We'll cut it open a little bit later in the video so you can see what the inside looks like. It's used powdered, dried, or added to things like beverages, kombucha, where ginger root. So this is just cut and infused into the kombucha. And then also capsules, you can buy ginger supplements, and then you can just eat the root like this too, you know, slice it up into dishes. This is some kombucha that I made, just a fermented tea. And we can open it up. There's some, you can make it carbonated like this one is. And it's basically fermented tea, as mentioned. So there's a lot of those good bacteria in it. It is one of the higher sugar fermented foods. So some people don't tolerate it very well if they're really sensitive to those sugars. Or you can just have a smaller amount of it as well. And I want you to know that ginger originated in China, but it's been used for thousands of years in different traditional medicines, such as Japanese medicine and Indian, Ayurvedic, and European medicines, in Native American. For some of the same things and reasons that we're going to talk about today, and I think this is what sparked some of the research to come about, showing actually research-based science on what ginger can help with. And a lot of it is in alignment with what ginger had been used for thousands of years now. So let's start by talking about ginger for pain and for inflammation, which is something that it's very notable for. Ginger, the active ingredient gingerol, or specifically 6-gingerol, has been shown that it can help with pain and inflammation. And in particular, the population that some good research is on is with arthritis. So if you know somebody struggling with arthritis, it would be worth trying to incorporate some ginger because it has been shown that it can help with the inflammation, the pain that comes about from arthritis. The other thing is stomach inflammation. So gastritis is the word for that in the medical community. Gastritis just meaning stomach inflammation. And ginger has been shown to improve comfort and reduce pain from that inflammation. Now, sometimes gastritis or stomach inflammation is caused by something called H. pylori, which is a bacteria infection. We do have research on ginger for H. pylori. It showed that it can decrease the H. pylori bacteria. However, it's not strong enough to be used as a treatment. So if you are struggling with H. pylori and have gastritis from that, ginger can be used to help with the pain that goes along with it, to help kind of soothe that tissue. But you should work with your provider to treat the H. pylori infection. Ginger does have some research showing that it's antimicrobial, so you know, which is why it can help to decrease some of those bacteria from the H. pylori, but ultimately just isn't strong enough if there's a, you know, major active bacteria infection. So the next thing we're going to talk about is whether ginger can help with the movement of the intestines. So as mentioned in the last video, our whole gastrointestinal tract really starts in the mouth, goes down to the anus. Mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine, out in stool. So when we talk about movement, we're talking about that peristalsis is what we say in the medical world, or just that movement of those intestines. And a lot of things are needed to be working properly for us to have proper movement of that intestinal tract. And the research shows that ginger can help with bile secretion. Bile is important for fat absorption and also for that motility movement on the intestine. Ginger has also been shown in the research to help with blood circulation, which helps the overall gastrointestinal tract too, and that motility, helping it work properly, which can help people who are struggling with constipation or can help with preventing constipation. And then you might know if you have ever struggled with constipation, which most people have, even if it's just, you know, traveling constipation, that when you are more constipated, you don't have a bowel movement for a day. We should be having 1 to 3 formed bowel movements every day. If we don't, then that constipation can lead to other bothersome symptoms like the bloating, uncomfortableness, maybe some gas. So going as upstream as we can, helping with that peristalsis, that movement of the intestines, helping to prevent constipation can help prevent some of those downstream effects, and ginger has been shown to help with this. Further, what's interesting is we have some research showing that ginger can help with expelling gas. So it can help to break down gas and just help it release from that gastrointestinal tract. And then the last thing is that we have some research showing that 2/3 of a teaspoon, so think of maybe your thumb tip as a teaspoon, 2/3 of that, so a small amount, has been shown to help with the movement of our stomach. So if you know somebody is struggling with something called gastroparesis or slow stomach movement, that ginger might be able to help with the movement up there. So again, stomach between our esophagus and between our small intestine. And then that can really help to set things up more downstream for that motility movement as well. So to review, with digestion, ginger can help with stomach movement, can help with the bile secretion for intestinal movement, motility, and then can also help to expel unwanted gas, all helping to prevent or helping with constipation. And now let's move on to nausea. So this is one of my favorite things to recommend ginger for. I have some personal experience using ginger as well. Growing up, I was very prone to motion sickness. I would throw up on long car rides. I had moved to Boston, some of you know, for a year to do my internship at Brigham and Women's Hospital. And while I was out there, my parents were visiting and we decided to go whale watching. I took Dramamine, which is a medication for motion sickness, and still threw up overboard the whole time. It was awful. So shortly after that, somebody recommended I try ginger. And honestly, I was so surprised by how well it worked. It worked better than the Dramamine, and Dramamine makes you sleepy, so it's not really that fun to have to take. Ginger doesn't. So now I use ginger, I keep it in my suitcase, I keep it in my car. Sometimes I have it in my bag just to be safe. This, I'll show you this again a little bit later, but these ginger people gingins are really great for traveling. They just use little ginger chews. So I think you know the answer already. Yes, ginger can help with nausea, and research shows that just 1/4 teaspoon twice a day help to decrease the risk of virus-induced nausea by 63%, which is pretty awesome. A lot of the research is in nausea from pregnancy, which certainly, you know, ginger would be a safer remedy than some of the medications. And yes, ginger was shown to be able to significantly improve pregnancy-induced nausea, and then you don't get the side effects from the Dramamine, which I just told you about. So I've found this to be true, that ginger was as effective as Dramamine, and honestly, it was more effective for me personally, and really low risk to just trying it out, right? So how do people take ginger? There are different ways. I already told you my favorite way is just using some of those ginger people candies, because it's just so easy to grab and keep places. I love the taste of the fresh ginger root, so sometimes I will just cut off a slice of this. I'll show you how much in a little bit, but I'll cut off a slice of this. I'll add it with a little stick of cinnamon. You can use some other spices, some of those warming spices, and it tastes really delicious. I think it tastes way better than just ginger tea that you buy in the tea bags. Tea bags are another way to get ginger in. I'm from Minnesota, I know I say big. Weird, but I think you all know what I'm saying. And then you can cut some of this off, chop it up, use it in cooking. And there are also ginger capsules on the market. I would encourage, you know, in this instance to just use the ginger root in some form, because I think it's easier to find good quality ginger root versus having to do all the research to make sure that you're buying a supplement brand that is a good quality that you can trust. There's a lot of concerns with the supplement industry. So if you want to go that route, make sure to check with a dietitian. If you're my client, you can check with me so we can make sure you get you on a good quality brand. So most of the research on ginger was done on 3 to 5 grams of the fresh root, or a 1/2 to 2 teaspoons of dried root. So I just have a cutting board down here. So let's just do this. I want to show you about how much 3 to 5 grams of fresh root is. So we're gonna chop off a little bit. Just kind of a side note, this is how you hold a knife. Don't do this, your risk of, you know, letting it slip and slicing your fingertip is higher. So you wanna grab onto the knife like that. This also isn't very stable. I went to a knife cutting class once. So now I'm trying to show everybody, you know, the safest way to chop with a knife. So let's just cut off here. Let's do these 3 little bits and see what this comes up to. So just power this guy on. And so the whole root is 108 grams. And that bit isn't even registering. So let's just add a little bit more. And then we have 9 grams. So slowly kind of take off, and there you go. That's 4 grams. So 3 to 5 grams of fresh root. So if you just took that, chopped it up, put it in some hot water, maybe with some cinnamon, it would make for a really delicious tea, or chop it into your cooking. It's good to know that most consumer product teas have about 2 to 5 grams of herb per tea bag. So, you know, maybe about half of this. And sometimes it's mixed with other teas, spices and things. So it's not all ginger. So just be cautious of that. I guess not cautious, just be aware of that when you're out buying ginger tea. And if you do it with the fresh root, I really think it tastes better. And then you can kind of change the amount of spice per your preference too. So kind of win-win. So just to review it, ginger has been shown to help decrease inflammation, decrease pain, especially that stomach pain if someone's struggling with gastritis, can help with that movement of the intestines, can help with expelling gas. I don't think it's going to totally get rid of the gas after eating beans, but your family might appreciate if you tried. And then the last thing, but my favorite thing to recommend ginger for, is nausea, and especially great for pregnancy-induced nausea. Kind of research shown that it's as effective as Dramamine, so it can be a really simple and safe intervention. So I want to thank you so much for watching. If you haven't already, subscribe, like this video, that really helps me. If you have an idea for a future video, please just post it in the comments below, and I'll keep a running track. And I love making these videos, bringing some science-based information to all of you. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again soon. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Bye.